The Tearsmith's conclusion is as plodding and formulaic as the rest of the Netflix production. The plot is on two adolescent orphans, Nica and Rigel, who are adopted by a kind couple. It is based on Aaron Doom's best-selling novel of the same name from 2021. Together, they overcome their shared pain and demons to acknowledge their love for one another. A voiceover introduces the spectator to the heartbreaking tale of the Tearsmith, a guy who created crystal tears for those unable to cry. Then, after losing her family in an automobile accident, Nica makes a comparison between herself and the Tearsmith at the orphanage. Years later, an even older Nica and an orphan from their rivalry are finally being adopted. We observe as the two young newcomers find comfort in one another and gradually develop feelings for each other as they enroll at a new school, make friends, and make enemies. The movie is about the two teenagers facing their problems together as we see how their stay in the orphanage traumatized them. The motion picture. We're going to have a traditional high school dance at the conclusion. Because of his moodiness and his refusal to acknowledge Nika's want to be with him, Rigel refuses to attend, pouting at home despite her obvious affection for him. At the dance, Nica is dancing with a boy that she used to despise since he had hit Rigel, and it looks like they are having a nice time. Rigel is on his way to the dance, but he later changes his mind and heads back home. Because Nica is feeling hazy, she decides to go somewhere quiet with Lionel. When she urges him to stop kissing her, he refuses and continues. Arriving at the dance, Rigel pushes Lionel away from Nica. Nica proceeds to liken Rigel to a wolf, reminding him that not all wolves are evil. As the camera moves around them, they hug, kiss, and strip. Lionel's retaliation. In maybe the strongest acting scene in the film, Lionel confronts Nica and Rigel as they are making their way home because he isn't going to let this go. When the two decide to flee, Lionel jumps into the river below and speeds them down the bridge. Unable to swim, Rigel gradually sinks. When the movie shifts to Nica in the hospital, she recalls that Rigel, not her closest friend, was the one who had held her hand when she was younger. Because of his prior medical issues, Rigel is in a coma and his prognosis is not good. Nica makes the decision to take Margaret, the orphanage owner, to court in order to release everyone. In the closing scenes, Nica defends herself in court and speaks about bravery and love. Nica makes a passionate statement that is met with acclaim before running in a disorganized, slow-motion fashion to the hospital to see her still-sick partner Rigel. She informs him that the lawsuit was won. She calls him her Tearsmith, the only person who can bring her to tears, and she rests her head on him while the tears stream down her cheeks. Her tears, like to a fairy tale, cure him, and he emerges from his coma. The last images show a montage of their shared lives, including Nika's family, friendships, and growth from childhood to the present. It has a nice, healthy conclusion. It's just as plodding and formulaic as the rest of the movie, but it will make you feel satisfied. Do Rigel and Nica wind up dating? Through extended, occasionally eerie looks and close-up exchanges, the peculiar friendship progressively takes shape. Although they appear to detest one another, it turns out that love and attraction have always existed alongside this hatred. When we first meet as youngsters, we find out that Rigel has always supported Nica, holding her hand through difficult times and even preserving her necklace that was pulled from her neck. Rigel didn't desire a family. He consented to be adopted so he could be with Nica. In the process of conquering their inner demons and prior trauma from the orphanage, the two come to love and a life in each other as they attempt to form new friendships and move on from their past. After a lot of ups and downs, the two eventually declare their love for one another, and it seems clear that they will be a couple. In order to provide Nica with the family she has always desired and to ensure that their eventual union is not weird, Rigel chooses not to be adopted by the Milligans. What brought Nica to the orphanage? When Nica and her family are first seen driving, Nica notices a wolf. Her father is driving and swerves into oncoming traffic while trying to spot the wolf. It is evident that Nica was placed in an orphanage after the passing of both of her parents. She endured years of torment and misery here before being taken in by the Milligans for adoption. The Milligans decided to adopt two kids to adore and share their family with after losing their son not too long ago. Nica is able to start again with these two as her parents and Rigel at her side because she has always desired a family. Thanks for watching, and if you're new to channel, subscribe and click the bell so you don't miss out latest videos of Media Breakdown.